So, Vivo has recently launched the Vivo V23 Pro. Now, in case you guys don't remember, the Vivo V series is known for having some of the best selfie camera in the segment. And this time, they have two selfie cameras. With the same flash as before, but with a lot of twists, which makes me really excited to test them out. And straight up, you get this big V23 box. And if you look closely here, the box is all glittery like those school scrapbooks. It has a texture to it, and if I change the direction of the box, the font V23 Pro changes color. Nice. Get the phone, you get a silicone case, paperwork, some stickers, 44 watt adapter, earphones, SIM card ejector tool, type A to type C cable, type C to 3.5mm dongle. Dude, this is like Doraemon's pocket. How many things does this phone have? Put everything aside, the phone is quite one-handed. I feel Vivo's phones are very well built and easy to hold. The phone is very slim at around 7.39 mm and the weight is around 172-173 grams. Now here, at the bottom, you have Type-C port, single speaker, SIM tray. By the way, two SIM cards, no SD card support. But the base variant starts at 128GB and you also have a 256GB variant as well. The volume rocker, power button are on the right. Noise cancellation mic at the top. Now, the real magic is on the back of the phone. Now, I have kept it hidden in my hoodie, but you see, the color of the back is now golden. But as soon as you expose it to some UV light, well, it's happening. You can now see it changes to bluish green or some tealish color. Nice. It's one of those features that I didn't knew I needed in a smartphone, but now that I have seen it, yes. So now we were trying to see whether the color changes if you have a case and whether it can be done by indoor lights. So now we have a strong studio light, and guess what? So if you have a strong enough light, well, yes, the color changes. And. Now, not only people around you, but even your phone can change color. And the back is made up of glass with a texture. And the frame is polycarbonate. You get a 1080p 90Hz full HD AMOLED display. It's an HDR 10 plus display, but what does that mean to you? Well, it can play HDR on YouTube. It also supports Wideband L1, so you can play 1080p videos on Netflix, although no HDR support on Netflix. But what about Amazon Prime? Yes, you can play 1080p videos on Amazon Prime right out of the box, which is great. And it's not a flat AMOLED display, it's a curved AMOLED display. Now, the bigger notch at the front is due to two reasons. Number one, it has an extra wide-angle selfie camera. Now, I have loved the extra wide-angle camera on Pixel 3, the original OnePlus Nord. But sadly, companies, in order to make the notch smaller, just remove the ultra wide-angle camera. Great that it's back on the V23 Pro. And number two, you have this two spotlight LEDs on the front. Now, the Vivo V23 Pro has 50 megapixel main sensor. Now, if you remember, on the Vivo V21, you had OIS on the front camera. Now, let's check if this thing has OIS. Now, the main camera can shoot 4K 60fps, and now I'm walking swiftly to see how good the stabilization is. And now, let me try and run a little bit. And I've always wanted to vlog while running. It's one of my those favorite tasks to do. Now, the Vivo V23 Pro also has a Steadicam feature, which drops the video to 1080p 30fps, but it intelligently crops your face and tries to keep it in the frame. And now I'm trying to walk a bit. Not trying, I'm actually walking. But let's see how well this works if you run. Can it? I can see it keeping it well. So there are again steps. Hopefully this does a good job. Also, this is very cool. You have a teleprompter built inside the app. So if you're someone who has to record a lecture or even a short reads, just upload your script here and you can start reading stuff like a parrot. Now, let's check the ultra wide angle selfie camera. You can record videos through the ultra wide angle selfie camera, but it is only limited to 1080p 30fps. Now, recording through the ultra wide angle selfie camera gives you the option to have more people in the frame as well as a lot of area to cover. And I'm always a fan of wide angle camera. Personally, I've preferred wide angle camera more than a telephoto lens. Now, you can also shoot portrait bokeh videos, which is again like portrait photos but in videos. And now, since this is a 50 megapixel main sensor, it has a lot of data to crop on, and it's not doing a bad job. Like my fingers, if I keep on switching and bringing it back, okay, it's not at all bad. Like, in the viewfinder, it's not bad. Now, the phone cannot switch between the ultra-wide-angle camera and the main camera while the video is on. So, that was one feature that I really missed. And I think the Dimensity 1200 can handle that. On the rear camera, you have an 108-megapixel main sensor. You also have an 8-megapixel ultra-wide-angle camera. And of course, you also have a 2-megapixel macro camera. So just like the previous year's Vivo V21, this one also has eye autofocus. So if you see over here, it uses your eye to keep you in focus even though if I move out of the frame, which is really good. Now you also have the option to shoot dual videos, which is like you can shoot videos from any of the two cameras, either the front main or ultra wide or the rear main and ultra wide. You cannot simultaneously switch while recording the video, but you have to decide it before. There's one more thing. Now these huge studio lights you see over here, I don't like it because it doesn't give you the option to adjust the white balance or color of it. But now, since we have all the lights off, here's Vivo's spotlight flash, and I can even change the white balance of the light. I can make it more warmer if you see here, or I can make it more colder. So I always love lights where you can change the white balance and make it more warmer, because personally I like warmer skin tones. Now the main deal is the processor or system on chip. The choice is really good. The Vivo V23 Pro comes with Dimensity 1200D with 8GB LPDDR4X RAM and UFS 3.1 storage. Now, it's a well-tested MediaTek flagship. It runs pretty cool and I don't see any big throttling issues in the phone over here. And we tried N22 and it scored around 644,008 is what you call it. But mostly, it was very cool while doing it. Now, in BGMI, Dimensity 1200 performs really good. I've tried with Nord 2 as well, the same chipset. So you can play at max HDR graphics and ultra frame rates. And you can go smooth extreme frame rates, that is 60 FPS on smooth graphics. So we'll do that. Am I playing good or the opposite team is bad? And one thing which I really liked about the device, like, it's 2022 and the phone comes with Android 12 right out of the box. This is FunTouch OS 12. First of all, FunTouch OS 12 has now completely shifted to Google Dialer, Google Messages and Chrome browser. You would get this every time.
This call is now being recorded.
And you have the usual hot apps, hot games, which you can click on home settings and just disable. Gone. FunTouch OS 12 also brings some good widgets here. Now, Android 12 widgets are dynamic. Now here, if you see, you can interact with this music player widget. I can change the source from local music player to Spotify without even opening the music player app. The same goes with the weather widget. I can see the weather on different days or even throughout the day without opening the app by just tapping and swiping through the widget. I'm really excited about tons of good Android 12 widgets that will change the entire widget game on Android. Now, you get 4300 mAh battery with the Vivo V23 Pro and 4200 mAh battery on the Vivo V20 base variant. Both of them have 44 watt Vivo flash charge. Lastly, you get all the sensors, gyro, compass, etc. You get 7 bands of 5G. Now that we have so many 5G bands, all we need is 5G. So for 4G carrier aggregation, I couldn't find 4G Plus with my Airtel SIM. So I went outside and checked with my Jio SIM and I could get 4G Plus at some places. So the stability can be further improved with updates. Now, I'm not sure about the pricing of the Vivo V23 Pro, but as per rumors, it's going to be around 37 to 40,000. There's also a Vivo V23 base variant, which carries more or less the same front camera features, but with Dimensity 920 and 64 megapixel rear camera. That will start at around 35,000 or even lower. That device couldn't reach us on time. Now at 35,000, you also have Vivo's 2020 flagship, Vivo X60 in the offline market. Now do remember, Vivo X series will receive 3 years of Android updates and security updates. So you can consider Vivo X60 as well. Really good phone, and consider is the important keyword. This is not a full review. On that note, this is Pratik signing off. You can watch X70 series and Vivo V21 video over here. I'll see you pretty soon.